Hello friends, welcome back. Thank you so much for your great support. Friends, today's video is preparing just like restaurant style chickpeas or chana curry. So check out the description box for more information about this recipe. Here I have soaked 1.5 cup of chana or chickpeas for 4 hours, which I'm gonna cook it in the pressure cooker, adding little salt, turmeric and also oil. So mix once, then we're gonna cook it in the pressure cooker for 5 to 6 whistles. You can use high flame to cook. So this way of preparing curry, you can serve with rotis, rice. So here, once the cooking is done, you can see the chickpeas are perfectly cooked and ready for the next step. So here, for the next step, we gonna grind 3 to 4 tablespoons of chickpeas along with 1 medium size of potato which is already cooked. I'm gonna grind it as a finely paste. So now let's go for a curry preparation. Here I'm adding 1/2 cup of oil, cooking oil. You can add tablespoon of ginger paste, tablespoon of garlic paste, little turmeric. So cook this for 1 minute or until the raw smell goes off. You can use the high flame since we have already added enough oil. So add 2 big onion finely chopped, which I'm gonna fry it along with the ginger garlic and also turmeric in the oil. So well, again the onion takes 3 to 4 minutes. We need to cook until the onions get slightly golden brown color. Then you can add 2 tablespoon of chili powder, tablespoon of garam masala, tablespoon of coriander powder, 1/2 tablespoon of jeera powder. So fry 1 more minute until the raw smell goes off. You can continue the same flame. Then you can add 2 big tomatoes, salt for the tomatoes to cook. Cook it for 2 to 3 minutes by closing the lid. So friends, here we are adding one by one ingredients and also we are preparing the very tasty curry. So once the tomatoes are cooked, you can see the tomatoes have become super soft. You can easily smash it. Then we're gonna add the grinded aloo and chickpea paste or potato or chana paste. The paste is thick, but you still can dissolve it with the other masala. So which will take again 1 minute. You can cook it 1 more minute until the oil gets separate. You can see silky kind of gravy. So this is the perfect texture for most of the restaurant style gravy or curry. So you can use this way of curry preparation for most of the restaurant style curries. So you can add chickpeas, dry mango powder, salt as per the taste, dry methi herbs, 1 tablespoon. Mix it well. So let it cook for 5 more minutes in a medium flame. So after 5 minutes, you can see the gravy is almost done. Finally, add unsalted butter, fresh coriander leaf, chopped 2 green chilli, cook it until butter get melted, then the gravy is ready or curry is ready. Superb, very tasty, goes so good with the rice, all Indian breads. You can give it a try, you will like it for sure. So let's check out today's motivation. The best view comes always after the hardest climb. So friends, thank you. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.